military weapons.
Hello and welcome back, where today we talk about the Rockwell B-1 Lancer. Now, the Rockwell B-1 Lancer is a supersonic, variable sweep wing heavy bomber used by the United States Air Force. It is commonly called the Bone. It's one of three strategic bombers in the United States Air Force fleet as of 2017, with the other two being the B-2 Spirit, or stealth bomber, and the B-52 Stratofortress. In the early 1990s, following the Gulf War, and concurrent with the disestablishment of SAC and its reassignment to the newly formed Air Combat Command, the B-1B was converted to the conventional bombing use. It first served in combat during Operation Desert Fox in 1998, and then again during the NATO action in Kosovo the following year. The B-1B has supported US and NATO military forces in both Afghanistan as well as Iraq. The US Air Force had 66 B-1Bs in service as of the year 2012 in the month of September. The B-1B is expected to continue to serve well into the 2030s, with a Northrop Grumman B-21 Raider to begin replacing the B-1B after 2025. The B-1s currently in inventory will reach the end of their service lives by 2045. Now, unlike the B-1A, the B-1B cannot reach Mach 2 speeds. Its maximum speed is actually 1.25 or 15,030 kilometers per hour. However, its low-level speed is increased to Mach 0.92 or 1,130 kilometers per hour. The speed of the current version of the aircraft is limited by the need to avoid damage to its structure and its air intakes. To help lower its radar cross-section, the B-1B uses serpentine air intake ducts and fixed intake ramps, which limits its speed compared to the B-1A. Vanes in the intake ducts serve to deflect and shield radar emissions from the highly reflective engine compressor blades. The B-1's main computer is the IBM AP-101, which is also used on the Space Shuttle Orbiter and the B-52 bomber. The computer is programmed with a jovial programming language. The B-1's defensive electronics include the Eaton AN-ALQ-161A radar warning and defensive jamming equipment, which has three sets of antennas, one at the front base of each wing and one the third rear-facing in the tail radium. Now, also in the tail radium is the AN-ALQ-153 missile approach warning system. Beginning in 2014, the B-1 was used by the United States against the Islamic State in the Syrian Civil War. Then, from August of 2014 to January of 2015, the B-1 accounted for 8% of United States Air Force sorties during Operation Inherent Resolve. The 9th Bomb Squadron was deployed to Qatar in July of 2014 in order to support the missions in Afghanistan. But when the air campaign against ISIS began on August 8th, the aircraft were employed in Iraq. During the Battle of Kobane in Syria, the squadron's B-1s dropped over 660 bombs over 5 months in support of the Kurdish forces that were defending the city. One-third of all bombs used during OIR during the period, killing some 1,000 ISIL fighters. The 9th Bomb Squadron's B-1s went Winchester, dropping all weapons on board 31 times over the course of their deployment. They dropped over 2,000 JDAMs during the 6-month rotation, and the B-1s from the 28th Bomb Wing flew 490 sorties, where they dropped over 3,800 munitions on 3,700 targets during a 6-month deployment. In February of 2016, the B-1s were then sent back to the United States for cockpit upgrades. Now, as part of the United States Air Force organizational realignment, they would announce on April 2015, all B-1B aircraft are to be reassigned from Air Combat Command to Global Strike Command, which will be effective as of October of 2015. On July 8th of 2017, the United States Air Force flew two B-1 Lancers near the North Korean border in a show of force amid the increasing tensions, particularly in response to North Korea's 4th of July test of an ICBM capable of reaching Alaska. Of its general characteristics, it carries a crew of four with an aircraft commander, a co-pilot, an offensive systems officer, and a defensive systems officer. Its height is 10.4 meters, with a wing area of 181.2 meters squared. The empty weight is 87,100 kilograms, with a loaded weight of 148,000 kilograms. Its max takeoff weight being 2,016,400 kilograms. Of its fuel capacity, it can carry a 37,900-liter fuel tank, each in 1-3 internal weapons bays, a power plant of 4 General Electric F101 GE102 augmented turbofans with a dry thrust of 77.4 kilonewtons each. Its thrust with afterburners equals 136.92 kilonewtons. Of its performance, its max speed at altitude is Mach 1.25, or 1,040 kilometers per hour at an altitude of 12,000 meters. At low level, it's Mach 0.92, or 1,100 kilometers per hour at an altitude of 60 to 150 meters. It can carry a range of 9,400 kilometers, and its combat radius is 5,543 kilometers. A service ceiling on this is 18,000 meters, with its rate of climb being 1,731 meters per minute. Wing loading is at 816 kilogram meters squared, and its thrust weight is 0.38. Its armament features hardpoints with 6 external hardpoints for 23,000 kilograms of ordnance and 3 internal bomb bays for 34,000 kilograms of ordnance. Its bombs feature 84 MK-82 air inflatable retarder general purpose bombs, 81 MK-82 low drag general purpose bombs, 84 MK-62 quick strike sea mines, and 24 MK-84 general purpose bombs, among others. Previously, it had up to 24 B-61 or B-83 nuclear bombs that could be carried. The number of these machines built, the B-1A was 4 and the B-1B was 100, with the unit cost of approximately $283.1 million in 1998 for the B-1B. Thanks for watching this video. If you liked it, be sure to subscribe and turn on your notifications for more. Also, give it a thumbs up and leave a comment, and we'll see you next time.